She is the founder and director of Kathalaya's International Academy of Storytelling. Kathalaya means the house of stories. Storytelling was a childhood passion for Geeta, who later transformed storytelling into a creative methodology during her years as a teacher and librarian. Kathalaya was established in 1998 with the vision to make a positive change in education through stories. Kathalaya has trained around 93,000 individuals in the last two decades by way of their workshops and globally recognized courses. The certificate is affiliated to the International Institute of Storytelling, Tennessee in USA, Scottish Storytelling Center, UK, and University of Skoda, Sweden. Kathalaya has entered the Limca Book of Records for conducting the first international festival in India in 2005. It has reached out to over 5 lakh children so far. She tells, "The universe is made up of stories, not atoms." So Geeta Ramanujam has this to her credit because it is the only credible and globally recognized academy for storytelling in the world with affiliations to USA, Scotland and Sweden. She is an Ashoka Fellow and has widely traveled to 43 countries and the 27 states in India to establish storytelling as a tool of learning and also to set up centers. She also has awards to her credit, including the recent International Award for the Best Storyteller at Bacadio Storytelling Festival at Brazil and the Governor's Award in Tamil Nadu for the Best Story Narrator. She was also recognized and mentioned by our Honorable Prime Minister Modi ji in the Mann Ki Baat program. Really, it's a pleasure to have her today and her team, Rohini and Deva. We welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you, madam. Having great fun from the morning, and all that energy comes from you because you have been so supportive. And for a storyteller, it is very important to have energetic listeners, isn't it? Especially children. And I feel that the best, most healing part of storytelling is when children listen and they look at you and they do exactly what you're doing and they feel happy, isn't it? So as always, I would like to begin by saying thank you and gratitude to Acharya Pathshala School Institutions for inviting me today. After nearly 6 months, I must say, I'm doing this offline and I'm not seeing children inside squares. Okay, so I can see children, I can feel children, and I'm sure children are very happy now. Are you happy, children?
Yeah.
Very happy. Okay, when you're happy and you know, you clap your hands. Do you know the next line?
Yeah.
When you're happy and you know, you clap your hands. When you're happy and you know, you clap your hands. When you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it. When you're happy and you know, you clap your hands. Does it mean that the adults who are seated here are not happy? No. Are parents happy?
Yeah.
Very happy.
Yes.
Because I am the happiest today. Though I'm a grandmother. Can you believe this? No, no, because we all have a child inside all of us, isn't it? And we all love to feel that child inside us. So when you're happy and you know, you snap your fingers. When you're happy and you know, you snap your fingers. When you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it. When you're happy and you know, you snap your fingers. When you're happy and you know, you slap your thighs. When you're happy and you know, you slap your thighs. When you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it. When you're happy and you know, you slap your thighs. When you're happy and you know, you say hello. Great! Louder! When you're super! When you're happy and you know, you say hello. When you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it. When you're happy and you know, you say hello. When you're happy and you know, you do all four. Super! When you're happy and you know, you do all four. Good! When you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it. When you're happy and you know, you do all four. Hello! Huh? No, that is in the end. Okay. So, let me see. Somebody wants to say hello to you. Deva, the table of it. Yes! Yeah! Woo! Woo! Okay, Tutu. I'm just reminding him that we are in a school and that he has to sit. Will you be quiet, Tutu? Very quiet. He's thinking. He's saying, I won't be very quiet, but I'll be quiet. Good, no? Yeah. Okay, Tutu. The children all love you, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. And you love the children?
Yeah.
Oh, that much. Okay. So, Okay. He has a request. He wants me to tell a particular story. Okay? So shall we go by what Tutu wants?
Yes.
Good. Good. Okay. I'm going to let him sit and listen to the
story.
Children, I want to ask you something. Do you like coming to school? Because I also loved going to school. You know, I went to school in 1960s. Long ago, right? Okay, so I went to a lovely school in Mumbai. Because I was born and brought up there. And I went to a school called the Little Angels High School. Now, it was called Little Angels, but we were not angels at all. Okay? So, when we went to the school, we had very strict teachers. Not like the teachers you have today. The teachers had a long scale. Big foot ruler. It was double the size of the ruler that you have today. And they would come like this on top of the stage. There would be a table and they'll keep that foot ruler in that table. And we all had to stand up before our teacher comes to the class. And we all had to get up and say, good morning, miss. And the teacher will say, sit down, sit down. And she will say, thank you, miss. Now, in our class, we were a co-education school, which means both boys and
girls.
So, when we went to the school, my classroom, this was in my fourth standard. Which standard?
Fourth.
And my classroom was on the third floor. So, we had to climb and go and we had a long corridor. like a passage. So we had A, B, C, D, E classes. Okay, so I was in fourth A. And we had a, those days no buzzer. We had big bell outside. So every time after the class, when that man came to ring the bell, no, it will go dang. And we used to shut our ears. We had very strict teachers. And one of the teachers was our maths teacher. And since we were co-education school, one boy, one girl, one boy, one girl, we had to sit. And we had small benches, very small benches. Now, I used to sit in the first row because I was very thin at that time. And next to me, there was a boy who sat. His name was Raju Vagle. And he was... So when he sat next to me, he would sit... Boof. And every time he sat on the bench, I'll fall down. So every time both of us will be pushing each other. Now there was one more thing that he had. He was a very, very, very nice boy in his heart. And he was a wonderful person. He used to share things with everyone. There was one more trait that he had, that physical trait. He had two of his teeth. It was always awesome. So all of us will tease him. We'll say, we can grate coconuts on your teeth. He'll say, Goya. But very nice boy. So, now, before lunch, we had our class teacher's period and then we had maths. My mother, she was also very strict because she was very good with counting. And she said, Geeta, you better pay attention today. Because I used to write answers like 4 3/4 men, 7 1/2 buffaloes. Can there be 7 1/2 buffaloes?
No.
And my mother would give one dung. And she'll say, wooden head, wooden head. Better pay attention. So I told Raju, Raju, today don't disturb me because I'm going to pay attention. And now our maths teacher entered and we all stood up. Good morning, miss. Sit down, sit down. Thank you, miss. We sat down. Then on the board, she wrote fractions. You all know what fractions are, right? Yeah, so she wrote fractions. And then I was seeing her because she was like me, how I'm on the stage now, no? Like that. And we were all down. So for me, my teacher looked like one 70mm picture. And she said, if you take an apple and cut it into half, you'll get 1/2, 1/2. Now for me, I was wondering, how can an apple be so big? And I went into apple land. And what happened? That is the time when Raju decided. So he pushed me because he wanted to adjust. And what happened? I fell. And there was a sound. And I got so angry with Raju. And he had big hands. So what I did is, I pinched him. Toy! And he did, ah! Now the teacher, she heard the sound. She dropped everything and she said, Raju, stand up. Stand up, I say. Raju stood up and said, show me your hand. And she took that foot ruler. And Raju was doing. And she pulled his hand.
And he said, but she only, she.
You're talking.
One putt. No, but she only.
Again you're talking.
One more. And poor thing, Raju got beatings. And she told Raju, out of my sight. Get out of my class. And Raju was crying. And he went outside. Now, I got the whole bench to myself. It was nice, but inside my heart, I was feeling very bad because I pinched Raju, no, and he got punished. Not fair, isn't it? So my teacher said, now pay attention. And she said, if you father cut the apple, you'll get 1/4, 1/4, okay? And then she gave homework, and then the bell rang, dang! And it was lunch time. And during lunch, we always share our food. So we didn't have a compound to play at that time. And one more thing I must tell you, in those days, our school was the first school that had a water cooler. You know what's a water cooler, right? Yeah, you press and you get cold water. And it was the end of the long corridor. So within half an hour, we had to finish lunch, we had to drink water, and we had to come back before the teacher came to the class. So we, four of us, would share the lunch. So what happened? My mother had sent only one laddu that day. So I know Raju likes laddus. And I felt bad, isn't it? So I went out and I said, Raju, Raju, come here, let's share lunch. He said, I won't talk to you. Then I said, my mother has sent laddu. It's only for you. Laddu, And he came inside. Then he took the whole laddu. I finished eating and I wanted to go and drink water. So I went at the end of the corridor and I pressed and I was drinking. I was drinking the water. I saw this man who was going to ring the bell. I said, oh my God, I must go back to my classroom. In the meanwhile, Raju, he finished lunch and he saw that this man who was going to ring the bell. So what did he do, you know? He came out of the classroom and he started running towards the water cooler. I saw the man who was going to ring the bell, and from the water cooler, I started running towards the classroom. And he is running towards the water cooler. I am running towards the classroom. And he is running. And I am running. And taka, 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 taka. We both ran so fast that we... Dhamma. And all I know is I saw stars. And I fainted. Because imagine Raju banging into me. And the next thing I knew, that man carrying me down, the principal, my mother, they are putting water. And there was a big injection. In those days, no disposable. Big glass syringe with big needle. And one patak. Oops. And then the doctor said, she has to be taken to the hospital. So they took me to the hospital. And there... the doctor said, Beti, don't cry, okay, because I'm going to stitch. What is going to stitch? One big cut over here. And he stitched and I cried. He put 12 stitches. And he told me, I'm giving you a present, but don't open it now. No school for 1 week. Every day, dressing. So I went home. My mother was very sweet. And after 1 week, somebody rang the bell. Ting tong. My mother opened the door and it was my class teacher. She was so sweet, she came home to see how I was doing. And behind her was Raju. So she went to talk to my mother and Raju came near me and said, hey, how are you? Yeah, how are you? And I saw him. And I said, Raju, what happened to your teeth, yeah? And he said, I don't know how I lost it. And that's when my mother came from inside and she gave me the present. There were two books, lovely books to read. One was the story of the ungrateful man and the other a circus book. And then there was one small dibba. And in that dibba, she said, open it. When I opened, guess what was inside? Guess what was inside that box? The tooth! There were two teeth. And Raju saw it and said, my teeth, my teeth, my teeth! You know what had happened, right? When we banged into each other, his teeth had got stuck in my forehead. And it had cut my forehead. And the doctor had to remove both the teeth and give the stitches. But unfortunately, it was Children's Day the next day. And we had a great celebration and there was an announcement that my father got a transfer and that we had to leave that beautiful school. So I always remember that school. And later on from that book, I told stories to children. And I use this even now. And I tell the story of the ungrateful man, of
the tiger, was actually very good, was actually very nice. And it was him who helped the storyteller and told the storyteller, save all the animals, but don't save the man.
So, there was also another sound from the well of the
I wish I lived in the monkey land, the land where I was born. Hey, my friend! Oh, my friend, if you're feeling hungry, you come. And that's what monkey told the storyteller, but don't save the man!
And then there was the snake. And the snake said, trust in me, but don't trust the man. And this story I liked because the animals and our environment that we are destroying today, we are destroying the animals, the birds, and man is surviving. But man is the man who is destroying our forests and bringing all the climate change. So don't destroy the snakes. Don't destroy our tigers. We all need them for our environment. And this book was given to me in 1960. So I tell this story and I'm very grateful to that school for having given that beautiful gift to me. And I treasure this childhood memory of mine. I grew up, became a storyteller, and after 20 years I returned to Mumbai, went to my school and met an old friend. And you know what she said? She said, you remember Raju? I said, of course I remember. Now he's grown up, he's an architect, and he has two children, a boy and a girl. And the boy looks with two teeth. Thank you. The story from the other book, someone is here to share. I'm going to invite Rohini to share that story.
Can you hear me?
No, no.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay. Habari watoto habari. Habari za asubuhi. Mimi ni Rohini Chidambaram. Did anyone understand what I was saying?
No.
Okay. Is it an Indian language?
No.
Yes? No? Okay, it's not an Indian language and it belongs to East Africa. It's spoken in East Africa. Any guesses what language I was talking to? Africans, they speak different languages. And this language is called the Swahili. What is it called? Swahili. So when I said Habari Watoto, which means hello children. Habari Asubuhi. Good morning. Anyway, happy Children's Day, everyone. Okay. So, why did I speak in Swahili, by the way? To make you learn and what else? Because we are going to travel all the way to Africa. We are going to travel all the way to East Africa. Yes. So let us all count 1, 2, 3 in Swahili language. So you'll repeat after me?
Yes.
Yeah. So one, mojo.
Mojo.
Billy. Tattoo.
Tattoo.
Okay, once again. Mojo, Billy, tattoo. Yes. So in East Africa, they have a very special way of inviting and welcoming their visitors. How do you think they invite the visitors? In India, when people come, we say namaste and we also sing and dance, isn't it? What do you think they do there? Yeah, musical instruments, you feel? Okay. Okay, by the way, let me just tell you.